Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, Bible reading and prayer. And that which fell among thorns are they which, when they have heard the word, go forth and are choked with the cares and riches and pleasures of this life, and bring no fruit to perfection. But that on the good ground are they which, in an honest and good heart, having heard the word, keep it and bring forth fruit with patience. Luke 18:14-15. The Bible is the greatest book in the world. It is a book from God, about God, penned by God's men and about how to be God's men and women. Here is what the Bible contains: love, adventure, war, mystery, politics, above all, God's plan for man. To really know and love God, we must learn to love the book He gave us that reveals Him to us. We do not love God more than we obey Him. We do not obey Him more than we obey His word. St. John 8 put it like this: Then said Jesus to the Jews which believe on Him, If ye continue in my word, then are ye my disciples indeed, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. In essence, the word teaches us who we need to become. The Bible is God's inspired word. 2 Timothy 3:16 reminds us, All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. God's word is eternal. Isaiah 40 said, The grass withered, the flower faded, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Let us look at what David, a man after God's own heart, had to say about the scriptures in Psalm 119:89. He says, Forever, O God, thy word is settled in heaven. There is a difference in knowing the word and living the word. Some study the Bible to argue, but they don't live the word. To some, the Bible is just another literary work and not an eternal word. The devil can quote scriptures more than all of us combined, yet he detests the word of God. It is in the word we learn how to pray. Prayer makes a difference no matter what the situation is. There is power in prayer. Prayer bothers the devil, shakes nations, saves souls, and brings revival. Jesus' disciples came to him and even asked him, Lord, teach us how to pray. Jesus said, pray after this manner. He did not give us a literal script for prayer, but a pattern. Now, let's examine the pattern for prayer. Begin with praise, honor, and thanksgiving to God. Pray for God's will to be done. When we pray for God's will to be done, He will help align us to His will. Pray for your daily needs. Don't let it be like a Christmas list. Pray for God's forgiveness, that He may forgive us, just as we forgive others. Pray God will deliver you from temptation and deliver you from all evil. And then you end your prayer with praise and honor and thanksgiving to God. We need to establish this one precedence in our lives. I choose to pray. The choice is yours. Nobody can make that decision for you. Not everyone is called to preach. Not everyone is chosen to be an usher. Not everyone is able to sing or play the instruments. Everyone is called to pray. Everyone is chosen to pray. Everyone is able to pray. God always answers every prayer you pray. Just because God does not answer your prayer the way that you want Him to, doesn't mean your prayer is unanswered. Prayer is so essential that God said in 2 Chronicles 7:14, If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land. Don't just think about dinner and a movie. Try to include the word and prayer. The thought of the day: there is a difference in knowing the word and living the word. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.